20 years ago, Genelec introduced the original 8000 series. Now an industry standard, it revolutionized the audio industry for its innovation and sound performance. Join us as we take a look at the story of why and how we made the series.
I think the motivation behind creating the 8000 series of monitors was driven by a strategic decision to focus on monitor quality rather than simply pursuing cost reduction. The decision to focus on making better monitors was crucial in staying competitive and meeting market demands. The creation of Tokyo Speak by Harri Koskinen, which later evolved into the 6040A, provided the team with an excellent starting point.
The forefather of the 8000 series is 6040, and it was actually a work of art that was originally created for a Japanese design exhibition. And after that, basically this design with its potential benefits stuck in our minds as a source for a new line of products that we would like to bring out.
I remember back in those days, there were active design work ongoing and there was prototyping. I remember the plasticine waveguide tests. It was years before the launch of the new range. And actually all those tests, they were done with identical drive units. So it was taken from the older 1000 series, but then the updates were made for the waveguide, the cabinets of rounded corners and improved directivity. And subjectively, the differences were really big.
Actually, it always came as a surprise to me, the different ideas they had. You can imagine, the 1000 series had ports on the front here, and we wanted to fit this massive curved port in somewhere. I saw prototypes where the port opening was on the top, where it was down here or here in the middle, and everywhere really. Yeah, we simulated, tested, listened, tweaked over and over again.
The 8000 series was a milestone in Genelec history and development of our product line over the years. But it took quite a bit of time before this was accepted on the market. If you remember, back in the old days, and still today, most of loudspeakers are, you know, fairly sharp corners. And when we came out with this, people were actually saying that, "Now, what are you guys doing? No, because a loudspeaker is not supposed to look like this. It's supposed to look like a box with sharp corners. That's a loudspeaker." Before this, you know, we actually had a product with the name of 1022. And 1022 was pioneering this concept. These round shapes avoid the colorations that the sharp cornered enclosure creates. So this was something that people noticed very soon. And then after a couple of years, there were no more questions. Everybody was accepting this approach because it was giving such a great benefit.
The 1000 series was very iconic. It has been in production for many, many years. Back in the days when the discussion started that we should have another, like an improved or new range of loudspeakers, we knew that whatever we do, it needs to be drastically better, because people were so used to the industry standard 1000 series. Also, of course, at the same time, there was nothing wrong with the 1000 series, so it worked really well. It still does, but all those improvements, they needed to be found, and it was mostly small-ish tweaks, so making the aerodynamic shapes, getting rid of the reflex ports from the front face, making room for the waveguide, things like that.
If you think of the technical benefits of 8000 series design, the benefits that have a lot to do with the acoustical quality of this design. What we have here is a directivity control waveguide for the tweeter. And this is essential because it enables us to create a neutral audio also for the off axis. The roundness reduces splashing of audio at these edges and corners of the enclosure.
So back then, the design team was much, much smaller than it is now. And similarly, our spec sheets were way shorter as well. It was really just a single sheet of A4, which had all the relevant specs for all three products. And one thing I remember clearly was this requirement for serviceability. And we were saying, well, what do you mean? It has to be easily serviced. What does that mean? And I think it was a colleague from America who said, got to be repairable with hand tools only. You've got to be able to open it, fix it, close it in half an hour kind of thing. Just hand tools. So Genelec, but actually so relevant today as we go forwards with talking of right to repair and sustainability.
If you think of the longevity of 8000 series, some of the things that I should mention is, first of all, that this aluminium is mostly recycled aluminium. So this is the old soda cans and other aluminium objects that have been recycled to this form. It's a very solid, robust design, and I think this is one of the key factors that has made this 8000 series design so popular.
It was recognized that where the improvements could be made compared to the 1000 series was in the low frequencies. There was a lot of work related to the low frequency improvements, so the woofer drive units, they were optimized for clean output at low frequencies. And of course, when you do that, you need to put out also a lot more sound through the reflex ports, which is in the rear of the cabinet nowadays.
So all of these different factors make 8000 series so useful and solid in everyday use.
As we celebrate 20 years of the original 8000 series, we remain committed to innovation and excellence. Here's to the next 20 years.